What's the reaction you've had from your constituents in Curtin to that, to the news over the last week on this issue?
The reaction I've seen is incredulity. And last night I had a community catch-up and there was a lot of shaking of heads and people just saying, you know, bewildered by this, saying, how can Peter Dutton destroy the certainty that we need here and say we're not even going to commit to a target before the next election? It's a bizarre approach to say, trust us on climate, we'll sort it out later. When the coalition has absolutely no credibility in that space at all. So, to me, it shows that Peter Dutton has learnt nothing from the last election and is refusing to be responsible on the biggest challenge of our generation.
Yeah, well, you were part of that that teal wave, albeit on the other side of the country, to those seats that fell, blue ribbon Liberal seats. I asked Sophie Scomps this earlier in the week and she said 100% yes, they believe, well, she believes, the coalition's given up on winning those teal seats back, including yours. Do you agree with that?
Well, to some extent, I don't care what their approach is to seats because this issue is much bigger than that. This is about the future prosperity of the country. So, you know, maybe they've given up on these seats and they're looking elsewhere, but I'm far more concerned about whether the coalition is making responsible decisions about the future direction of the country. And I think it's really, really bad that they're just kicking the can down the road. So electorally, I don't think it's going to be good for them. But more importantly, where now is the alternative viable government that is thinking about the long-term prosperity of the country? Because it's not the coalition.
What do you say to the argument that they're not going to get, the government, the incumbents aren't going to get to 43% by 2030 anyway?
Well, we need to set ambitious targets, and whether we get to 42 or 43, the important thing is that we are sending a signal to the investment community that we are on the path to decarbonisation. We want to get there. We want to make the most of our natural advantages in renewables, which are the lowest cost form of energy, and we continue to push as hard as we can. I think it's an absurd position to take to say, if we're not going to meet 43, we're going to abandon the whole concept of having a target. In no other field is that a valid or legitimate way of approaching working through a pathway to get to an outcome. So, you know, we may not make it to 43. I still hope we can. We're on track for 42 and we've still got 6 years to put the pressure on and to get there. We need to be ambitious in this area, not just for the planet, but also so that we have an economy that is prosperous in a net zero global economy. So it's really vital that we keep pushing. And I'm just appalled by the coalition's approach on this.
Kate Chaney, thanks for your time.
Thanks very much, Kieran.